It's been more than a month since the UK identified a new, more contagious variant of the coronavirus. And now there are multiple variants that scientists are keeping an eye on. And the Centers for Disease Control and Prevention says at least 32 states are reporting cases of these variants, with more than 470 cases and counting. So what does that mean for you? Britt Conway has answers to some of the questions you might have right now.
By now, variant is a word you've heard over and over again.
Variants remain a great concern, and we continue to detect them in the United States.
So let's answer a few questions you might have. First, what is it about these variants that has medical experts most worried?
The more infection there is in a community, in a country, the likelihood, almost the certainty, that there will be variants. And the virus's goal is to survive, so it will be the strongest variants that will eventually survive.
The variants that have been identified recently seem to spread more easily, and there's concern they could become more dominant in the U.S. by the spring. So what about the vaccine's effectiveness against the new variants?
Even though there is a diminished protection against the variants, there's enough protection to prevent you from getting serious disease, including hospitalization and deaths.
But what if I can't get a vaccine right now?
First, wear a mask, stay 6 feet apart. Second, please avoid crowds and poorly ventilated areas. Third, now is not the time to travel.
How will all of that make a difference?
There is less virus spreading, and the conditions that produce variants are decreased.
So public health measures and getting people vaccinated could prevent future variants too?
Viruses cannot mutate if they don't replicate. There is light at the end of the tunnel, but it's going to be up to us to step to the plate.
I'm Britt Conway reporting.